Hello student, in this video I am going to talk about two example. These example are basically about data science and business event. Through these two example we can know or we can familiarize with how the business can be profitized to big way, in a big way, using data science techniques. Or data science give us the enough opportunity to gain the profit from a business or to sustain the business. Here you can see one or first example. There is in 2004 by New York Times, there is a story that Hurricane Francis was on its way barreling across the Caribbean, threatening a direct hit on Florida's Atlantic coast. Residents made for higher ground, but far away, in Wentonville Arc. Now, executives at Walmart stores decided that this situation, which is bad situation for the people near the coast, but that situation might work upon in this Walmart store as a good situation. Decided that the situation offered a great opportunity for one of their newest data-driven weapons. Now, what is that newest data-driven weapons? That is predictive technology. It means they can predict something. They can predict their business. If some familiar event occurs, now they can predict. Now what they can do? A week ahead of storm's landfall, Linda M. Dillman, Walmart's chief information officer, pressed her staff to come up with forecasts. See, forecast based on what happened. What happened when Hurricane Shirley, this was a different hurricane which was happened earlier. So the information officer forecast pressed her staff to come up with forecast based on what happened when Hurricane Shirley struck several weeks earlier. So that Walmart obviously has trillions of bytes of word of shopper history that is stored in Walmart's data warehouse. So now they felt that the company could start predicting what's going to happen. Like here, you can see indeed, it would be more valuable to discover patterns due to the hurricane that were not obvious, because that type of thing to have to hurricane to come is rare, but sometimes it came. So if some data available during that time or the pattern of hurricane due to the hurricane, if we can find some valuable patterns or data in our warehouse, which is caused due to the hurricane, then it will be very, very, very valuable. It will be very, very valuable. So to do this, analyze might examine the huge volume of Walmart data from prior similar situations. Similar situation in this kind is the hurricane, such as Hurricane Shirley, to identify unusual local demand. So see here, unusual local demand, or you can say anomaly. If any hurricane happens, what type of demand rises, or what type of demand for some products rises, or some products it become low, for some product it become high. For such pattern, that company might be able to anticipate usual demand for products and thus stock to the stores ahead of hurricane's landfall. So this is the scenario how we can couple business and data science to become more creative. Here you can see more evidence. As per in New York Times report, the expert mined the data and found that stores would indeed need certain products and not just the usual flashlights. Flashlights are demand. That's all. Flashlights will be in demand, but not only flashlights. But during that Charlie, Hurricane Charlie, that Walmart did not know in the past that strawberry Pop-Tarts increase in sales like 7 times their normal sales rate ahead of a hurricane. And also that information officer said in a recent interview that pre-hurricane top selling item was beer. So you can see now how they are related somehow. But in the data that exists, but we have to find out using data science technique. So this is one example. Now we'll go to second example. Here the name of the example is predicting customer churn. Churn is a people here, a human being. Assume you just landed a great analytical job with Mega Telco. This is a big company, suppose one of the largest telecommunication firms in the United States. Now they are hiring major, they are having a major problem with customer retention in their wireless business. It usually happens for many telecommunication business. They might have problem to retain the customers. In mid-Atlantic region, 20% of the cell phone customers leave when their contracts expire, and it's getting increasingly difficult to acquire new customer. So here you can see two part. One part is that 20% of the cell phone customers leave when their contracts expire, and it is getting increasingly difficult to acquire new customers. Since the cell phone market is now saturated, the huge growth in the wireless market has tapered off. Obviously, if the phone market is low, then the wireless market will be also low. But how can you retain that extra 20% leakage? Okay, without acquiring new one, because to acquire new customer, you will need to spend more than the retaining them. So now problem is that communication companies are now engaged in battles to attract each other's customers while retaining their own. Customers switching from one company to another is called churn. Okay, customer switching from one company to another is called churn, and it is expensive all around. So one company must spend on incentives to attract a customer while another company loses revenue when the customer departs. So what to do? How can we establish any pattern? How can we find which customer to pay incentives so that we can attract the customer, so that we can retain them? Because to acquire new customer, we need to pay more. So now here already we said, assume you just landed a great analytical job in Mega Telco. Now your job is to understand the problem and devise a solution. Attracting new customer, which is more expensive than the retaining existing ones. So a good deal of marketing budget is allocated to prevent churn. We need to prevent that churning, or you can say outgoing or switching from one company to another. Marketing has already designed a special retention offer. Suppose that the whole marketing system already designed some special retention offer. Now your task is to devise a precise step-by-step plan for how the data science team should use Mega Telco's vast data resource to decide which customer should be offered a special retention deal prior to the expiration of their contracts. So now we can see here also, in this situation also, data science, how we can use the data resources to find a pattern, to find or to choose which customers need to be given some incentives, because the plan of providing incentive is already there in the marketing phase, budget also there, but it is your job to find the pattern or predicting which person to be given that retention deal prior to the expiration of their contracts. So now it is your job to find or to choose which data to be, or what data to be used, what data to be used, and how they would be used. So again, I'm going to say that in this course, later on, we'll discuss this type of example in different scenario, and we'll try to devise solution according to that, and we'll go through basic, from the basic of data science to complexity, complex data science problem, and we'll correlate those things with business models so that we can find or we can understand how data science can be very, very useful for business analytics. Thank you.